how we want to hold the government accountable, hold the cabinet and the executive accountable. So we want to look at structural reforms.
Questions too, but just to reflect on the answers just now, I think it's important for us as voters to recognize the difference in role of a parliamentarian in parliament and the role of a state assembly person. And that distinction can be seen from some of the points that were highlighted. On the spot to answer all three questions. Before we open it up, I think she's young, she's energetic. Media covered a lot about her and her family and who she is. So who she is, what are guiding principles, and what would she do if elected? What would you do if you're not elected? Let's give her a hand.
So I based in international business, doing international business. Does that answer the first question?
Okay. Which is what are your guiding principles in life and in public service? Let's guide
this. To make this country a better nation. Especially that I hope that with all these young candidates standing out, I hope that we can inspire more young people to also come out and serve our nation so that we can create more young people to be in this system, to be the change of the, to be the change as the social change agent. Yeah. During 2015, that time I was also a special assistant for salary opinion. So we run this research of what is the most thing that the PJS citizens, specifically Damansara Utama citizens, concerned about. And in this research, that the top two things that the people is concerned about is the safety and also, of course, a good environment and good surrounding. So, first of all, of course, if I am elected.
Thank you. Money politics and asking that, okay?
I have a company called Nehemiah, a civil engineer. I see that some of you on the stage will be voted into the corridor of power and influence.